Well, obviously, you don't have too many great nights such as this in your career, so to miss out tonight is a big disappointment for me. But I've had 2 weeks now to get over it, but the closer it actually gets to the game, the more disappointed I'm becoming.
Now, the atmosphere has been building around White Hart Lane. Somebody told me almost since early this morning there's already a terrific buzz in the ground. Is it getting worse and worse for you as the kickoff gets closer and closer?
Well, it seems to be, yes. You just, when you see the grass or you see the people coming through the turnstiles and the traffic coming to the game, then you realise, well, they're not coming to see you play. So but I've got full confidence in the lads, and I've managed to play 11 out of 11 games so far, so I could have missed some through injury, and I've been very lucky, so I've just had to miss one through suspension.
What is your role going to be then here tonight? Are you going to stay away from the team altogether or play a little part?
No, I've been with the team all season and I'm going to stay with the team. Hopefully I'm going to be allowed to sit on the line and give my encouragement from the line as I do on the pitch. I think that's the only way to be. I don't think you can detach yourself from it if they're used to hearing your voice all season.
There was talk about you going up to get the cup at the end. Is there anything in that?
No, I don't think so. The people that play tonight deserve to go and pick that cup up. If they do a lap of honour, should we win, I might be involved in that. But no, I'm not interested in that at all. I've always been a team player, and it's about the team winning tonight.
We might be anticipating things a little bit because obviously Anderlecht are a very good side. We can just have a look at the way they beat Nottingham Forest in the last round, and two of their goals here, Steve, that you know very well indeed.
Yes, I think the first one was scored by the lad Sifo. He picks the ball up there after some good challenges in midfield. Runs with the ball, which he's very good at. Doesn't seem to be too much danger at the moment. Comes inside, ends up on his right foot, and maybe the goalkeeper's a little bit unsighted there, but it was a great goal. The second one here, the ball gets cut out, unfortunately, for Forest. Then they're very quick here. The lad's got a great left foot, the number seven. Plays the ball into a great forward run, good control, and he just lobs it over the goalkeeper.
Now that's Vandenberg, who won't be playing here tonight. Finally, how much of a blow do you think that'll be for the Belgians?
Well, it will be a big blow because he's their main striker. Having said that, they brought in two very, very experienced players, Arnesen and Verkorteren. They are good, solid players for this club, and I think Anderlecht are pleased that those two are there.
Do you think we're all set for another glory night here at White Hart Lane?
Well, I hope so. We've all come for it, haven't we? So I'm very confident in the lads that will do it.
Steve Perriman, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.
Steve Perriman heading off to the Spurs dressing room, where he's still got a very important role to play. And at 1-1, it would be wrong for Spurs to be overconfident tonight, of course, but remarkably, they've never lost a European game at home. And this is their record at White Hart Lane in 10 campaigns since 1961. 32 wins out of 38, 120 goals against 26. And on European nights, they always seem to produce something special.
Hoddle will take this kick. Roberts at the far post, almost left. Deeney got in the header. Archibald! Roberts is giving it to Kraus. Hoddle's chip through. Falco! And it's gone in off the post! What Falco has done it!
The last-minute goal that got Spurs through in the third round. But, Jimmy Greaves, let's talk a bit about Keith Birkinshaw. His last match as Spurs manager, his last pre-match team talk going on now, I should think. What should he be saying?
Well, actually, I would think that Keith is probably not saying a lot, Steve. I think he probably has said what he wants to say throughout the week. I think the guy who will be really drumming him up will be Peter Shreves, because behind Keith's back, he'll be saying, look, this is the chance, you can do it for the fella. This is the evening that really counts. You can see Keith on his way with a win, and I'm pretty certain that Peter Shreves will be willing the players on like nobody, and Keith will probably have adopted his reasonably calm attitude towards it and just given a normal team talk, really. But I'm sure Shreves will be there, really, behind them.
How much G-ing up do you need before a European final? Because, of course, you had experience 1963 in Rotterdam, yeah. Atletico Madrid.
Yes, we did, actually, and quite remarkably, I think Bill Nicholson was a bit down in the dumps because Dave Mackay was unfit and Dave was our best player. And he fancied that Atletico Madrid, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
Yeah. It's a long time ago, Steve, son, I'll tell you that. He fancied them as a good side. And without Dave, he was very worried. But it was Danny Blanchflower who got behind us and really got us going.
Yeah, and I think perhaps you're a bit too modest to say that you got a couple of goals that night. In 1972, it was the UEFA Cup final. Martin Chivers scoring the goals that gave Spurs a 2-1 lead in the first leg at Wolves. And in the second leg, a goal by Alan Mullery clinched the trophy.
And it'll be Martin Peters hitting one. And Mullery's got it!
Mullery and Chivers, the stars of Tottenham's last UEFA Cup success. They're back at White Hart Lane tonight, once again talking with Jim Rosenthal.
Well, Alan Mullery, I mean, what an atmosphere building up here with, what, an hour and 20 minutes to go to the kickoff.
Marvellous, Jim, isn't it? Fantastic. It brings back happy memories, you know, just watching that on the television there, scoring the winning goal. Marvellous.
That was your last game for Spurs. I'd just like to ask you, what makes Spurs such a special team here in Europe?
I don't know, they're just, I mean, you can tell by the atmosphere, Jim, the people alone. I mean, they make it, really. I mean, the glory days, I mean, when they were singing and creating the noise they're creating now. I mean, I think it just used to frighten the life out of people. And that's the reason why we're so good.
Martin Chivers just coming across to you. Jimmy Green saying in the studio that Keith Birkinshaw won't have to give a talk before this game. The players won't need any motivation at all. Would you agree with that?
I'd agree with that, Jim, yes. I don't think they need any motivation. The atmosphere's here, the stage is set, and I think Tottenham will go on to victory.
What sort of game do you think we're in for then tonight?
I just think Tottenham should take the game all the way and not sit back if they score the early goal like they did last time. I think it's all made for them this evening.
Now, Alan, what about Keith Birkinshaw, a fellow manager, although you're not in work at the moment? What do you think is going through his mind now?
I think he'll just savour every minute of it, Jim. You know, if he's leaving the club as he says he is, this will probably be the greatest night in his life, you know, as far as being manager of Tottenham Hotspur is concerned. And if they get the victory they should get, you know, with the way they played out there, he'll never forget it. He'll never forget it. I mean, I can look back on that when Martin scored the two goals in the first leg and I got the win in the final. I can recall that immediately now as we're talking. So you never forget nights like this.
Do you think, Martin Chivers, there's a danger, as a former player yourself, that too much is going to be expected of these players and they might freeze on the night here?
That's a possibility, but I just can't see it after seeing the first game. I don't see these boys freezing up on us. I don't think they have really a lot to beat.
Alan, what's your view?
I'm a little bit more, you know, cautious than Martin. You know, I've been in the game as a manager for 8-9 years now, and I don't think any game is finished until it's won. And looking at them out there, I think they'll probably enjoy the game a little bit better tonight because Tottenham have got to go and score goals. But they've got so many good players, Anderlecht, that they may have a chance of scoring goals. If they score goals, Tottenham are going to find it difficult.
Briefly, would you like to turn the clock back and run out there?
Love to. And I'd love to see Jimmy Greaves wearing a suit for a change.
A lot of people would like to see you out there, I know. Thanks very much to you both.
Great atmosphere. So we're a little more than an hour away from the kickoff now. Brian Moore and Brian Clough will be our commentary team among that capacity crowd at White Hart Lane. We'll be bringing you the whole game live, the programme starting at 7:45. Join us then, but from Jimmy Greaves and myself, goodbye for now.